All right, guys, it's Friday evening. Let's just do a little wrap-up show. So we had the tranny mount deal this week. Of course, that failed. I have already sold both tranny mounts. They're both already shipped. They just won't do for me until I find something else. I'm perfectly happy with the way it is right now. I was just noticing this gap. That's pretty big right there. It's nice and small, and at the top it gets big. Let's check the other side. Oh, good. It's the same. That's all I cared about. But, hey, on this Plasti-Dip, I'm just amazed with its quality. So first, it's like it's a thick lip. This isn't like paint. I mean, you can definitely feel a lump there. You can't probably see it. But it's thick, right? And the biggest testament to this is that we just had our biggest rains probably the year. Huge storms, two or three times. And I thought this thing would just get destroyed, and it actually doesn't have like one rip or chip anywhere. That's just dust and dirt that I can clean off. But I was amazed at how heavy duty this actually is. And if it doesn't chip too bad on this worst storms we had, then it should hold up real nice, because it isn't a super quick job. I don't really relish doing this job, you know, every like 6 months. It's a pain in the butt. So I'm hoping it would last a good 6 months without getting too bunged up. And so then I'd be happy to do it a few times over. I was thinking this is probably even more sturdy than spray paint, because spray paint's a lot thinner and it's not rubbery. It could take rock chips in a worse way than this Plasti-Dip, which is rubbery and soft. It could deflect a few rocks here and there too. So anyway, I'm really happy. The Plasti-Dip might have been one of my favorite mods I've ever done on the car, because it just changed the appearance so much. The power of this car is just magical. I haven't got used to it. I haven't changed my mind. I still love it. I probably told you about how that whole tuning thing kind of ended up, where I think we stuck with map 9, probably. I can't remember now. I think it's 9 is my final rev. And see if this garage door closes properly. And it's just amazing power. It's perfect. I don't even want it any faster. It's plenty fast. And I'm just really stoked with it. So let's just go for a spin. So I'm loving the sound and the tone. The power is just so instant, so amazing. Anytime you step on it, it's just right there and it just freaking goes. It has so much better throttle response than before. I mean, I know that old Stage 2 tune wasn't finished technically, so that's fair enough, but this thing just pulls so hard all the way up from about 2.5. It pulls the same strength up to about 6. And I have taken the concerns of the super cold weather we had. Some people have mentioned it. I knew that from the start. He tuned it for probably our 45 degree weather. And I'm definitely concerned when we do hit, you know, 80, 90 degree summer sometime or other maybe, that this tune will not be safe. It's gonna probably get a lot of knock, because it's a very aggressive tune that works great in this cold weather. You can see it's about 59 degrees right now. So anyway, this car is super fun. Anytime I step on it, oh my god, it just goes. And I can hear more spool now too. I can hear more spool because there is more spool. In a nutshell, this tune has more boost, more PSI, and that was directly noticeable in the sound too. In my older Stage 2, I couldn't even hear the spool anymore. It was just so weird. It was such a weak Stage 2, but I didn't realize it until I got a proper Stage 2. Now I can hear the spool. I think I can't tell if my exhaust from that resonator video, I don't know if it's gotten quieter or louder, if it's the same, But whatever it is, it's perfect. It's just exactly what I want. For a while, I was just kind of thinking about getting the STI midpipe to replace this custom job again. But I mean, the longer I kept it, there's an STI. The longer I kept it, the more I just said, why am I gonna spend $300 on an STI midpipe? This is the best the car has ever sounded. It's just an excuse to waste money or something, I guess. So I said, this is just perfect. Whoa, it's just so killer. So anyway, this is the best my car has ever been since I've owned it. I love the car the most now since I've owned it. I have no intention of doing more power mods at the current time, I guess is a fair enough thing to say. It just doesn't even cross my mind. Now, a couple things I might think about in the future. Brakes are entering my mind a little bit now because I have this killer power, and I'd like the brakes to be a little bit better. Now, you know how OEM plus I am. I don't like any major mods, so I definitely am not going to do any big brake kit. One, I don't want to. Two, I can't even start to afford it. And I also don't really want to do the STI conversion that so many people do. Just putting like older STI Brembos on this thing. What I really want, ideal for me, which I'm sure doesn't exist because that's what always happens with my wants. I just want a rotor that's a little bigger and pads that are a little better. Of course they have pads. They got all kinds of sets of pads I could buy. But I don't think they make just a tiny bit larger rotors, which I can use on everything else stock. My same calipers, same pads even to begin with. Maybe start with just slightly bigger rotors. Because for me, I want to keep it close to OEM as possible. And just a little bit more rotor will give me a little more bite and just a little more cooling, things like that. So for 2016, I might be researching rotors and brakes a little bit, doing some more cosmetic stuff, because mainly because it's cheap. I'm trying not to put anything else on the roof because you know how that went last time. And I do like to keep this thing pretty incognito. It looks pretty stock. I sure surprise people when they think I'm stock and it looks like a Camry, and this thing just goes like a bullet so hard. So, cosmetics, brake stuff, that's about it. A couple interior pieces. I have something coming for the interior in the next, probably not for a whole week, and I'll go ahead and show you that when it comes in. Nice cheap stuff, because it's easy to buy the real cheap stuff, you know, when you're only spending 20, 30, 40 bucks at a time, stuff like that. Anyway, that's it now. Oh, on the Naziok forums, there's been a little bit of talk about the exhaust strap on the J-pipes. It's just one thread. I mean, you can find it if you just go simply to the FA Engine forum section, and you'll probably see it right there. And it's just a lot of confusion, I guess, and different opinions on whether the ground strap is really needed or not. First off, Brandon hopped in later in the thread there and said that they actually think it's needed because they said that a couple of their boards fried on their dyno or something from a car that didn't have it. I mean, that sounds pretty strange, but hey, if they said it happened. And another thing, but then other vendors were quoted as saying that you don't need it and it's fine. Now, you know, I have the clamped ground strap on there, and I took that off today, and I attached the strap to a bolt on the side of the engine block. Now, I learned of that bolt from the thread that we're talking about. There's just one bolt on the side of the engine which is in reach of that strap. Now, I'm still, I think, attached to the exhaust pipe itself is better than the block, but I do think attaching it to the block is better than nothing. The clamp, although I do think it was definitely a ground point, although it also definitely had more resistance than a proper ground point, because it wasn't curved and, you know, matching the contours of the pipe and all that. So I'm contemplating maybe just getting a tiny welded nut on there, just like everybody else, like most people do, and I think I finally convinced myself it's not going to just ruin my downpipe and destroy the value or nothing like that. If anything, I think it would add value. And it should just be a 2 or 3 minute job with my muffler guy. He could probably just tack it in two places in 5 minutes and be done. So I may do that, and then of course I gotta use a hacksaw very carefully and cut one of those little 10 mil bolts to half height or something so it doesn't bottom out. So I'm thinking about doing that. Depends if I have time to get out to the muffler shop. It should be a pretty quick job. Then I could feel a little better that the ground is just exactly where it should be. Anyway, that's about it for now. This video's longer than I wanted it to be already, so I'll talk to you guys later.